I knew this was going to be my favourite quickscoping sniper in Modern Warfare 3, literally the instant I fired my first bullet. Calling this weapon a monster is an understatement. It's unstoppable. The MORS, or MORS, is a one-in-the-chamber style sniper where you get one high-impact shot before each reload. Don't worry though, with the help of some attachments, the reload time between each shot isn't even that long. And the one shot you do get is pretty much always a one-hit kill, so you can absolutely still hit clips with this thing. Just don't miss your shots. Thematically as well, this gun is just awesome. Firing a laser beam railgun is so satisfying. I've already had too much fun using this gun, and I want you guys to enjoy it too. So let me talk you through the attachments I've been using, as well as something a lot of people overlook when it comes to building a good class setup. The perks. Using the right perks for classes like this is crucial for getting the smoothest movement and fastest aim down sight time, so please stick around for them after I've gone through the attachments to really get the most out of this gun. Anyway, let's go to the gunsmith and build the beast. Alrighty, jumping straight into the barrel attachment, I use the Crown 50 barrel. This gives you good sprint to fire speed, hip fire spread, move speed, and ADS speed at the cost of bullet velocity and aiming idle sway. You can all read, but I'm going to tell you anyway in case you're just listening. We're mostly picking this attachment for the ADS speed, and some of you guys will point out probably that the Downfall light barrel has better ADS speed on it. However, I found that the aim walking steadiness of this attachment, it really messes with you when you're trying to like get those mobility shots. If you're peeking around corners or jumping around corners, when you're aiming in, you're much less accurate than if you're using the Crown 50 barrel. So that's the reason I'm going to put this one on. And then in the laser attachment, we are using the SL Razorhawk laser light. As you can see, crazy stats on the aim walking steadiness, tac stance spread, sprint to fire speed, and ADS speed. The big con with this is that you do have a flashlight and laser that is visible whilst you're ADSing, but when you're quickscoping, you're basically trying not to ADS too much, so this isn't a horrible negative. Normally, I do hate having a laser or flashlight that's visible whilst you're ADSing, but this attachment is absolutely worth it. However, if you don't think the pros will outweigh the cons with this attachment and you don't want that laser visible, then I would suggest using this attachment, the Schlager PEQ box. This simply gives you a little bit of ADS speed with absolutely no cons, so you can't go too far wrong with this one. But honestly, the sprint to fire speed and the ADS speed on this first laser sight is just so, so good. Moving round, we don't need an optic on this. I think the stock default scope is absolutely fine. Like, I actually quite like it. So in the stock, we're using the Icarus light stock. Once again, we're going for those ADS stats and the sprint to fire speed. We do lose some aim walking steadiness here, but it's worth it for the amount of ADS speed and sprint to fire speed we're getting. And then in the rear grip, I've been running the OP980 grip. This gives us ADS speed, aim walking steadiness at the cost of some flinch resistance. This attachment is obviously great for making your ADS speed faster, but if you're finding you are flinching too much, then I'd recommend the CNTR6 grip, but don't put that on just yet because the perks will help us sort this one out. Let's whack this one on and move on to the bolt, where we're using the quick bolt. This simply reduces the amount of time you have to wait between your shots, so you can kill more enemies faster. Sounds like a pretty ideal attachment. And those are all of the attachments. Feel free to take a screenshot of this or whatever, write it down, build the class in game right now, do what you want. But like I mentioned earlier, using the right attachments will only get you so far in this game. I cannot stress enough how important the perks are for this build in particular, so let's go through them now and I'll explain just why they are so important. Okay, so this is the overall class setup. We can pretty much ignore the secondary tactical, lethal, and field upgrade. These are completely up to you. I just use a knife to get around the map a bit quicker, which I guess is quite nice, but you can use a pistol in case you miss shots and want to whip them out and get the kill. Tactical, literally, use whatever you want. Maybe you could potentially use the newly upgraded snapshot grenade that they buffed in this patch, but I personally just don't bother. I don't really throw tacticals that often. Throwing knife is there for a little bit of flair. We absolutely love that on this channel. Field upgrade, trophy system. I mean, you could run dead silence because we're not running covert sneakers, which is probably a good idea, but trophy systems are pretty useful as well. They help your team. Can't go wrong with that. And now for the important bit, the perks. So in the gloves, we're running the marksman gloves. This, like I mentioned earlier, helps us deal with that flinch problem that we've created with our attachments. Obviously, this does only affect you whilst you're ADS, but it also reduces that sway whilst you're aiming down sights, so you're much more accurate, more consistent with your shots. I did also actually try playing around with the commando gloves, and these did feel really good, to be fair. They let you reload while sprinting, so between your shots, you're still able to sprint around, slide around, and everything. They did feel really smooth, but I did just find I was flinching a little bit too much, which you could potentially sort out with the grip that I mentioned earlier in the attachments, but I found the marksman gloves do the job just fine, and we sacrificed the commando gloves for that. In the boots, I'm running tactical pads. Now, this is the most important perk for this class setup. I cannot say that enough. This is the most important perk. What the tactical pads do is let you start aiming down sight before you've come around the corner, or as you're coming around the corner, which enables you to basically get insanely fast shots off with this sniper. So rather than slide cancelling around the corner and then having to ADS once you finish your slide cancel and then you just die because you're too slow, this lets you start your quickscope whilst you're slide cancelling. If you're only going to use one perk that I tell you about today, please make it the tactical pads. Yes, you do lose the covert sneakers, but like I said earlier, you can run dead science in the field upgrade, or you can just grin and bear it and just run around the map like a loud person, just killing everyone. Doesn't matter if they can hear you if you're going to kill them. So yeah, please, please, please run the tactical pads. And then in the gear, I'm running Data Jacker. There's not really too much in here. Like the other options would be TAC Mask or EOD, potentially Ghost if you really want to. But I just found Data Jacker is a great way to let you know where enemies are at all times pretty much. And it helps you keep those kill feeds going. I did try the Blacklight Flashlight, which honestly wasn't that great. It didn't really seem to help me that much. So yeah, Data Jacket is definitely the way forwards. And then finally, the vests. So I've been running the infantry vest. It's just obviously the default one. It gives you a bit of move speed, which helps you get around the map a bit faster, but it's not that interesting. If you're looking for an alternative and you do find the infantry vest too boring, then basically any vest that doesn't mess with your perks is fine. So for example, we could run the engineer vest. We lose the lethal, but we gain an extra gear, for which I would probably use EOD or tactical mask, like I mentioned earlier. You don't want to be running the gunner vest because you lose your boots, the most important perk of all of them. Demolition vest, yep, that would be fine. It lets you keep those tacticals and lethals coming. Comms vest, again, that's fine. Extra gear slot, but you lose both tactical and lethal. Overkill vest is fine. You get the ability to reload while sprinting earlier. You can swap your weapons faster, and I mean, you lose your field upgrade for this, but that's probably worth it. In all honesty, looking at this, I actually think the overkill vest would probably suit this class the best, but still, infantry vest is great, don't get me wrong. The ninja vest, don't go there, you lose your gloves, can't be having that. And then the assassin vest, again, this is a good one. You permanently get ghost, and yeah, I mean, you can't go wrong with that. The other vests aren't really that great. They don't give you anything worth doing, in my opinion. But if you want to use any of these, that's fine, because none of them actually affect your perks in a negative way. So thank you very much for watching this video. I'll leave you with the attachment setup once again at the end screen. If you do use this class setup, let me know in the comments down below. It'd be great to hear from you guys. If you make any changes to it, then also let me know. It'd be great to see your guys' take on this weapon. But yeah, I'll leave you to it. Go smash your lobbies with this incredible class setup. Leave a like on the video if you enjoyed yourself. Maybe a subscribe as well, but you know, I can't force you to do anything. Enjoy, and I'll see you next time.